Usually for people who are interested in science, get also get interested in pseudoscience without knowing it. So how do you differentiate between these two? We are going to see using the example of pseudoscientist Sadhguru. So all I want to do in this video is give you tools that will help people who don't have deeper knowledge of science and its working to differentiate science from pseudoscience. These are very simple tools. All it requires is a little bit of high school science knowledge. That is the only prerequisite for using these methods, which I am going to tell you about in this video. The first thing that you need to do to propagate pseudoscience is simply point out that science is incomplete. Not just incomplete, you need to point out that it's not even fundamental. And whatever Sadhguru tells you is fundamental.
So you don't go about trying to observe the cosmos because you don't have a gallery view of the cosmos. You cannot. There's no place where you can sit and observe cosmos. And in fact, you cannot observe anything except what happens within you. Even if you take a telescope and look at the star is happening only the way it projects in your mind, isn't it? Yes? You don't see any star. This is the reason why you see stars which don't actually exist. Many stars that you see don't exist, but they're projected in your mind in a certain way, and that's how you know it.
In the clip you just saw, the first thing Sadhguru does is point out that there is no place in the universe from where you can watch the entire universe. He points out the incompleteness of science by saying so. But this does not stop here.
No human being has ever seen an atom. Do you know this? Forget about a proton, neutron, electron. Nobody has ever witnessed an atom. Even in a super electron microscope, you cannot see it.
In this clip, Sadhguru says that no one has ever observed an atom, which of course isn't true because we have observed an atom a multiple number of times. I'm even unsure that he even reads something about science or not. And now the question that you should be asking me should be that is science really fundamental or there is something else more fundamental than science, like what Sadhguru says. Look, science is not something stagnant. It's more about the process than it's about what's current understanding is. Maybe science is not the fundamental description of the universe at its current state, but it's the most detailed and most accurate description of the universe that we have on today's date. Now, talking of fundamental description of the universe, I'm going to ask you a question, simple question, that why the most fundamental description of the universe be human-centric? Because as far as we know, we exist only on one planet in our solar system. We have not seen any other place where humans can survive other than on land. And we are made up of matter, which creates only 5% of the universe. we are very small entities of the universe. So any description with humans at the center of it are like the Earth-centric solar system. Just like Earth was considered at the center of the solar system around which the planets revolved or the entire universe revolved, any human-centric theory is equivalent to Earth-centric theory of the universe. Now, moving on to the second point.
So when I spoke to this very top-level scientist, who's a Nobel laureate, and I was telling him that this is what it is, there was a group of them, and when I explained, this is how it is within me, what do you think? They said, Sadhguru, if you can give a mathematical backbone to what you're talking, this is Nobel Prize stuff. Can you give a mathematical background? I said, I'll never bother about the mathematics. It's true for me, and it has transformed everything that I am because it's true for me. Everything that I ever was changed simply because I touched this dimension within me. I don't wish to work equations for that. And anyway, Nobel Prize wouldn't mean anything to me. I would be too embarrassed by such things. So, this story, because I will make it so brief, there could be holes in it. If I make it elaborate enough, there'll be no holes in the story. It's a perfect theory. And we have proved it within ourselves that it is true. But you want to build a $10 billion instrument under the ground to prove the same thing, it's up to you. This can be experientially proved within yourself if you are willing to go into the depths of what this is. Because this is made exactly the same way the whole universe is made. If you go deep enough into this and you know how this is made, by inference, you know how everything in the universe is made.
That leads us to the second point, that's denying provability. In this example, it denies provability to the claims he made by simply saying that he has proven or they have proven those claims inside themselves. If you have proven something inside yourself, how can you be sure that it's not your imagination and it's universally true if you cannot test it outside your body or your mind? In science, what we do is we make theories, but we don't stop there. This is just the first step of doing any kind of science. What you do next is test them. You should be able to test them and verify them as universally true by establishing their repeatability with or without you. If they cannot repeat without you, then it's not universally true. So, in my third point, I'll be giving you the method that's used by almost all of the pseudosciences to claim their legitimacy. But first, let's watch him speak on it.
So, they understood this and they maintained this genetic line so strictly, and they established an energy source for this particular DNA, for this particular kind of genetic trend. And when they go there, they are not telling some god up there, they are just registering. This is me. I belong to this line. This is my gotra. This is my nakshatra. This is my kula. Means I am registering my DNA material. I am saying, this is my DNA. Do something to me. It is the most scientific way of handling it. Science gone bad. Technology not transferred properly. Today it's all mixed up, so it will not work the same way. If they had maintained those genetic lines, you could make it work like that. But now you fall in love with the girl next door, she could be anything. Your choices have become more important than maintaining those kind of things. I mean, society has changed, so those things have become irrelevant. But when things were maintained like that, it was a very relevant thing. It is a wonderful understanding of life, a fabulous understanding of genetics and how it functions.
Now, in this method, you realize that the science is being fitted or rather misfitted into claiming that the Gotra system was designed on the basis of DNA and genetic sciences. This may seem very plausible at first glance because you need to know a little bit of background to the theory, but not too much. So, even a 7th class student knows that 22 sets of chromosomes are almost randomly passed from either of the parent. It's a 50-50 chance which of the genes they will get from their father or from their mother, except for the last gene, that XY chromosome. So, Sadhguru claims that it was because they knew about genetics in some other sense, then he is wrong, because 50% of the DNA is ignored. Gotras are purely patriarchal systems. And not only that, on top of Gotras, we have caste system in India, and inter-caste marriages are banned. So, in Gotras, marriages were banned due to some genetic reasons, then in caste marriages would also be banned to follow the same suit as that of Gotra. But no, it's not the case. Only in Gotra marriages are banned and in caste marriages are allowed. So the gene pool is still restricted. So this whole Gotra system and caste marriage system have nothing to do with science. The thing is, there was no profession as a scientist in the medieval ages. The science came out of common people. But now, in modern times, we have scientists who dedicatedly do sciences, but the scientific method of making theories that explains the observed phenomena, then making predictions that predicts some new things, then experimenting. These three principles of scientific method were established very late, during the Newton's time only. My fourth and last point or tool to identify the science from pseudoscience is the misrepresentation or misassociation of sciences.
When they say, if you know the way these bosons behave and what they are, they're saying we will know the whole universe, the way the universe was made, we will understand. But you don't understand that you are also a bloody boson. In the cosmic space, you're just a boson. So you are as much as a Higgs boson in the universe. If you observe this, if you pay enough attention to this, you would know everything. But if you have not even paid attention to anything around you, paying attention to within you will be out of question.
So in this example, Sadhguru says that you can find all of the answers inside yourself and associates bosons, that's physics, with ourselves as biological beings. So he says that biology is causing physics, which of course isn't true, because you cannot find answers of physics in biology. That's the wrong way. You can search for answers of biology in chemistry, you can search for answers of chemistry in physics, and you can search the answers of physics in mathematics. But if you try to find answers of mathematics in physics, instead of a physics mystery in chemistry and a chemical mystery in biology, you will not find the answer, because it's not supposed to make any sense if you go this way. So the only thing that this will create is confusion. And that's what he does every single time. He creates confusion on purpose to make it look like that he is talking about science. But when you analyze his speeches or what he said, you will find deliberate and misleading use of science to promote lies. But like most of the people who don't know what a boson is, all they can do is simply differentiate between physics and biology, and that would be good enough for them to be able to detect that something is wrong about it. So if you like the video, like it, dislike the video, dislike it. And now I'm switching to Hindi because I need to make some important announcements on my channel. So dekho dosto, hamare channel ka ek saal complete ho chuka hai. To ye video mere 1 year anniversary ke liye kuch naya content dalne ke liye ye methods maine aapko explain kiye. Ye methods aapko kisi book mein nahi milenge kyunki ये मुझे खुद ढूंढना पड़ा कि क्या वीकनेसेस हैं इन pseudoscience की. तो ये टूल्स आपके हैं, अब इन 4 टूल्स को आप कहीं भी यूज़ करिए और इनके कोई शॉर्टकमिंग्स आती है तो मुझे रिपोर्ट करिए, और रिजल्ट्स अगर अच्छे आते हैं तो भी मुझे रिपोर्ट करिए, अगर रिजल्ट अच्छे नहीं भी आते हैं तो भी मुझे रिपोर्ट करिए. और अगर आपको वीडियोस और मेरा एफर्ट पसंद आ रहा है तो आप मुझे मेरी एजुकेशन में भी हेल्प कर सकते हैं मेरे पेट्रियन बन के, और इससे मुझे हेल्प मिलेगी अपने आप को सपोर्ट करने की ड्यूरिंग माई एजुकेशन टाइम। अगर आप मेरी थोड़ी सी भी हेल्प कर देंगे तो मेरे लिए मेरी एजुकेशन के साथ साथ ये वीडियो बनाना भी मेरे लिए पॉसिबल होता रहे। तो अगर आप चाहते हैं मैं ये एफर्ट्स कंटिन्यू रखूँ, मेरे वीडियोस को सपोर्ट करिए, शेयर कीजिए, सब्सक्राइब कीजिए, और पेट्रियन को वो तो आपकी मर्जी है, प्लीज़ कंसिडर डूइंग इट। थैंक यू एंड लेट्स मीट नेक्स्ट टाइम।